Hello and welcome to my feature highlights in September 2025 with SAP Datasphere. Another great month with lots of new features and enhancements with our two releases. So let's check out my top features in September. The first one, input parameters in task chains and transformation flows. So you can now define input parameters on the task level of a task chain and also for transformation flows. A scheduled transformation flow uses the default value of the input parameter. Input parameters defined in transformation flows can be used in operators within the transformation flow, with the exception of the Python operator in the Apache Spark runtime. A transformation flow executed as part of a task chain receives the input parameter from the task chain. So this will allow for more flexible usage of task chains and even nested task chains. The next one, email notifications in replication flows. So you can now set up email notifications to stay informed when individual replication objects fail in running a replication flow. So from both the replication flow editor and the flows monitor, you can now set up email notifications for failures of an individual object in a replication flow. Fiscal time dimension. So when creating a dimension view, you can now have the option for dimension type, standard, and fiscal time. You can use the new fiscal time dimension type to model your fiscal time periods and the columns that define their starts and ends. When you add a fiscal time dimension to an analytic model, a fiscal variant variable is created for this dimension. The variable can then be handled like any other variable. Its data type is derived from the fiscal variance column from the fiscal time dimension. Structure support for analytical models. In order to create restrictions and calculations across all measures of an analytic model, you can create now structures, and those structures help you to save time and of course ensure consistency in your calculations, as you don't need to create a formula or calculation for each individual measure. In the data preview, the structure members are displayed in their own section. When you use a structure member, in the drill down of a preview, the restriction and calculations defined in the structure member will be applied to each measure. Structures can also be used and enhanced in SAP Analytics Cloud. When the analytic model has measures and at least one structure, you need to define how the calculations should be prioritized. So again, all in all, very cool features helping you to use SAP Datasphere way more efficiently. Thanks for joining me this month for my feature highlight overview. And if you liked it, give me a thumbs up down here and keep following me on LinkedIn. Also, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to get the latest updates. Take care and see you soon.